All right, let's hope this motherfucker holds together today.
Yeah, like we've been talking for a while. Only like crashed on us like once, so I mean that's not bad. But yeah, this is gonna be an interesting week of Guns and Radio because we're doing the research for this song, "Grunt" by Izzy Stradlin. Unfortunately, I found out it was an instrumental. I was like, "Fuck!" Because like trying to find lyrics for this is impossible. I'm like, "Let me actually listen to the song. It's instrumental." So, double review this week.
Bullshit.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna spin the spot.
Yep.
Am I fucking here or not? Can you hear me or not?
No, I can hear you. I don't know what the fuck is going on with this shit.
I'm really getting over this awful fucking quick.
Yeah.
StreamYard, get your shit together and fix this shit or we're gonna jack Skype.
Yeah.
And say hell with this.
Yeah, but what the fuck? Anyway,
pissing me off. Anyway, what the fuck was I talking about for? I got to bitching. Oh. I lost it. Yeah, we're gonna spin the wheel and we're gonna get another song today that we're gonna review at the end of the So I guess we're just gonna shit talk and stuff while we listen to Grunt. We're still gonna listen to Grunt kinda in the
background.
And I guess we're just gonna bullshit and reminisce. Dustin's in a bad mood because I'm sick as shit today. So
yeah, unfortunately we both got sick. Luckily it's not COVID. So
yeah, luckily it's not. It's just some kind of freaking virus. So I got my whiskey. I got some beer. I think both of those things are good for a cold. So, well,
I'd say
got my inhaler in case I get to talk. Can't get to coughing and can't talk. So, yeah, bear with us on this one, folks. I know I say that a lot, but yeah, you just gonna give us a break, okay? And. Yeah, let's hit the intro.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Guns in Radio podcast. And now, give it up for your hosts, Chris Caputo and Dustin Bone.
Alrighty, it's episode 160 of the Guns and Radio podcast, and Dustin, should we spin the wheel and see what the second song we're going to be reviewing, Double Whammy Edition, this week? I mean, it's 160, we got to do something with the 10th episode.
You want to do it now, or you want to wait and do it right before the... Actually, let's do it now, in case it gives us any ideas for skits or anything.
Yeah, see? On the fly, baby. Let's do it.
Yeah, it might change this whole shit.
Two tickets and a room by Walking Papers.
A fucking course.
Of course. I was like, two tickets to paradise? Who covered Eddie Money now?
Oh, man. Two tickets and a room by Walking Papers. We didn't. Oh, Lord.
What the f-
We didn't exactly get Night Train in that respin.
Unfortunately.
All right.
Tickets in a room sounds like a ransom note you get in the mail.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit play on Grunt so we can kind of listen to it.
Yeah, let's get into that.
How dare you put an instrumental filler ass song on your track, by the way.
Yeah. I feel like there's a couple other is instrumental things we have to get rid of on the list, so.
Is there?
I think so. Well, I'll have to look through it. I know there's at least one more that we...
Well, if you know what it is, please let me know so I can delete it.
It was probably something like his fucking reggae shit he did on his later albums, I think.
I tried to vet all of this content, but it was way too much to sit down and listen to. I got most of it out of the way.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a good beer. I'm drinking Guinness, by the way.
Ooh. Oh, I don't say. Boy, we talk a lot.
Oi, lad.
Oi, laddie boy.
Let's do the whole show like this. Fuck it. Shit.
You're going to talk Irish. Oh, my God. O'Shaughnessy. Oh, we're about to. Seamus.
We're about to listen to Duff McKagan singing. God, Jay. Any fucking
yeah.
way.
Yeah. Actually, wait. Duff didn't really sing in Walkie Paper, so, I mean, we're pretty good. He just stick to the bass.
Oh, he doesn't. Okay.
Yeah, no, he doesn't sing in Walkie Paper. He probably just does backing vocals, but that's probably the most.
Yeah.
If it was really loaded, then we'd hear a lot terrible. Of. Yeah, if it was loaded, we'd hear like, out of 10, oh my God. I'm punk rock Duff McKagan.
This has potential if he would have threw some lyrics on it.
Yeah, I'm surprised. You could have just said the same thing like 27 times, and it would have been like, eh, it's not bad. Go get the ball. No.
Now we're about to get to the breakout, and he's going to go, "Err." That's why it's called Grunt.
It's probably like a vocal sample of, like, fucking, I don't know, like, the Hulk from, like, the TV show going, "Err."
Let me tell you what happened to me today. So I've been homesick from work for a couple of days. That includes today, which is why I sound like shit. And I apologize a million times, everybody, but that's, show must go on.
Exactly, man.
I don't want to get stuck on a week doing catch up. So today I was sleeping in my recliner so I could sit up, you know, and wouldn't drain all the shit in the back of my throat. And I had the window open because cat likes to sit in the window. And a damn squirrel came up to the window and he was eating something. And this little fucker is just sitting there at the window. My cat's going crazy. And he's just holding something in his hand, just eating it, like, with one hand. Like, what's going on in there? And he's, like, looking in the window right at my cat, who's, like, batting at him and shit. And this fucker knows that this cat ain't getting out this window. So he's just sitting there like, yeah, what's up? What you gonna do, bitch? And takes a bite of his whatever he's eating. Yeah, this little shit had, and man, I wanted to, like, grab my cat, strap his harness on him, and open that fucking window.
Let them loose.
Get him, boy. Like, yeah, scare the shit out of him. But it was one of those days I ain't felt like moving too much. So, what'd you come down with? You said you got sick too.
Yeah, it's just like congestion and shit. Like, I've been getting better the last couple days, so I don't sound as bad. I sounded worse, like, on the weekend. It was bad, but I'm almost through it, luckily, so.
Well, that's good. Well, I think we're at the end of our song. Oh, by the way, bonus show, 90,000 downloads. What's the update on that?
Oh, while we're at it, well, we're recording this before the poll ends, but right now, like, in the lead is you want us to do a random song review, so, you're gonna get another song review, it looks like, so.
Oh, cool. Well, we'll find out for sure, we'll announce it next week, and we might go and do a double shot next week and record the bonus show. Also, I don't give a fuck or quit. Move for your shit tonight. Fucking cat attack on the middle of the show. Come here. I'm sorry I hit you. Come here, baby. I didn't hit him hard. I just, like, swatted at him.
Yeah, you just give him a little nudge key.
Yeah, I'm sorry, baby. You know I love you. Now I feel bad. I didn't even do anything. Yeah, he knows I feel bad, so now he's going to look at me and be a little asshole. Okay, whatever. Sit there. He's staying out of the damn show.
Sit and cry.
You know, hell yeah, man. But yeah, what a fucking insane week it's been, man. Like, it's weird that you got sick, I got sick.
It's ironic. It's like, of course the shit happens at the same time. I think it's because, like, the temperature has suddenly fucking changed in the city. Like, I probably even where you're at too. Like, dude, like now it's like fucking summer for some reason, the beginning of May in Toronto. Like, what the fuck
is going on? It went from ice cold to Canada.
Kind of, yeah, pretty much. You know, like, it's crazy.
Yeah, that's the way it is here. It's been hot as hell the last couple of days, and humid.
Yeah, our summers are fucking humid here too, man.
It's been humid because it rained last weekend. And last weekend, we were under a flood warning, like the Jeff City River flooded. Holy shit. Which, I mean, most of Jeff City's supposed to be underwater anyway, and then they set up a dam and built a whole fucking city here.
Yeah.
So
you're like Atlantis, but not really.
We'll be someday. All this shit will be underwater one day when mankind's gone and ain't nobody alive to maintain that fucking dam.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. It'll be back underwater where it came from.
Atlantis, Missouri.
Dude, don't nothing suck worse though than when you get one of those flash floods. I remember we got one in Mississippi, and I was driving home from work that day, and the parking lot across the street had cars just floating like boats.
Oh my god.
And then these fucking people would drive, and they'd see the water, like you could see the fucking water. And I don't know what the hell they were thinking to keep on driving. So they drive straight on into the water. And then, of course, their fucking car is going to stall out. And then it's just going to float away. And then now they can't crank it because it's all flooded on the inside. And you just lost the damn car, like, at that point.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you do? You can float or you can sink. I mean, get out and swim, I guess.
Pretty much.
So, yeah, public service announcement. If you're driving some fucking where and you see a big-ass fucking puddle of water where there shouldn't be a big-ass fucking lake, don't just assume that you're going to drive straight through the fucking lake that's here where the road used to be.
Or you go to your house, get like a fucking something that you can like fucking boogie board or like kayak on, and then do it, go that way. Fuck it. That's why you always have a fucking canoe attached to your roof rack.
I'm gonna tell you, those guys with a small penis that drive them big ass trucks, they'll be the ones laughing when that goes down.
Yeah.
The rest of us will laugh at them the rest of the time. That's 90%. So
yeah, above 95.
Fuck, more like 99 if it was flooded that much. Damn, I'd probably yeah.
that's for sure.
I'd have been over this Jeff City flooding bullshit long ago if it was like that 10% of the time.
Yeah. Fucking floods, man. I mean, we haven't gotten much like flood wise, like in Toronto at least. Like, I think a couple of years ago, I think the subways got flooded because there's so much fucking rain at one point.
But that's
like the craziest ever been.
We had a bad flood because it snowed really, really bad at the tail end of winter.
Oh, and all that shit melted.
Yeah. All they did was they pushed it off the road into these big ass piles. And I mean, what do you do with it? You leave it, let it melt. Yeah. Well, then all of a sudden it started raining and it got real hot. And then the snow, well, then you had to get that hot. Just started raining, and then the rain melted the snow, and then it all washed into the water, and then it went over the dam, and yeah, we got flooded. It was a nice couple of days off work. I live up on a hill, or at least I did at the time. I still do, but I live up on a hill now, so I mean, good couple of days off work, because our whole parking lot was like a fucking lake. Because I drove by there while this was going on. See, when you flood like that, it ain't like that the whole city is just underwater.
Because
it ain't the whole city. It's parts of the city, like big chunks of it are underwater. Most of the businesses are open. The main highway is fine. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of these back and side roads that just get covered up to where, and you got to beware on the side roads now. Like if you get on the main road, you're fine for most part. Mm-hmm. When you get off on these little side roads, like where I work at, then you get you know, like you'll go over some pretty deep spots, but they do a good job here putting up like cones and shit. So, you know, you know to go around, you know to detour. So,
yeah,
I mean, we were forgetting about it. I mean, we didn't lose anything in it because, like I said, we lived on top of a hill. So when we'd go down, our street wasn't flooded. So our street would take us directly to the main street. Fuck, I was going to McDonald's, to the grocery store, shit like that, just like it was every other day. It was just it was like a free Saturday. I mean, if you left your car at work in the parking lot, sucks for you, I guess.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh man, don't we got a music video to watch here in a minute?
Yeah, so we were looking up like shitty / cringy music videos to watch. So I found this article, ultimateguitar.com says that this is one of the most cringiest music videos in rock. So
one of the most cringiest songs in rock, let's be real.
Yeah, yeah, dude, all I remember the song for, I don't know if you've ever seen that Family Guy episode where Brian has to rent a Hummer. And this is the only song that plays in the car throughout the whole fucking time. It's just fucking hilarious.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, and this is the only song that plays on the car.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So if you don't know what we're talking about, it's Look It Up by Kiss. The first ever video they did without the face paint unmasked.
Oh, man.
I believe. I think what it said. I don't know. I could be wrong. I don't know. Pot of Thunder, let us know. So
this is the Skip It era of Kiss.
I mean, some of it was okay, but just the music videos were ugh.
No, man. I take my Kiss with my makeup. If you don't want to put on the makeup, you shouldn't have started it. We finish what we started in rock and roll. Oh, by the way, if you like music videos, come back to our feed every Friday because we have Music Video Friday. Mm-hmm. Each and every Friday.
Oh, yeah.
What's this week's? I hope I hadn't run out of them because I only made 6.
Yeah. It was a trial run, but they've been pretty good, man. I've even been enjoying them. Like, looking back, I'm like, we actually watched these fucking music videos.
Yeah. Oh, Worlds Apart, Separate Ways was the last one.
Yeah. That was an interesting one.
And the one coming up, I'm sorry, Fat Girl, at the time you hear this recording, Fat Girl was the last one.
And, oh, it was probably the Steel Panther video I think we watched.
The one that's coming up this weekend before I have to make some more is your personal favorite, Caputo. I think probably the most legendary one, the one that we've referenced the most on this show of these old videos that we watched a long time ago. It's Dancing in the Street.
Oh, that we ripped that fucking music video apart, and God, I can't wait to relive that. That's gonna be good.
Yeah, and we'll make some more. I'll throw some more together, especially if I'm sitting at home sick and just want to do something on my phone, because I did all these on my lunch. I did 6 of these motherfuckers in an hour. So
holy shit,
they're not
one
hard.
Season of MVF, bro. That's it.
Yeah. They're not hard to make. I'll at least make another 6, and we'll get 12 out of a season.
That works for me. Amen. And speaking of seasons, we're still going through season 1 of Getting Dizzy With It each and every Saturday.
Oh, yeah. I got to upload that this week.
Yeah. I think we're already like about a quarter of the way through, I think. Because we're about before. I think this probably when this airs, it'll be either episode 5 or episode 6.
Episode 5 has already aired. Episode 6, I haven't uploaded yet. So.
Okay, so it'll be episode 6.
Yeah, at the time. It'll be episode 7 coming up this Saturday. The last one you heard was episode 6, and I don't remember what those episodes were. But yeah, we're in the middle of the first season and Getting Dizzy With It. And there's 14 episodes, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we're smack dab in
the 14 right after season 2, so
yeah, it's a nice change of pace for Saturdays. Plus, if you want to something else new from our feed, check out the Dustin Burcham show, where this douchebag Ooh. Named Dustin Burcham, whoever that is,
this is douchebag.
He's I sit down and I meet with really some of the most interesting people in the world. That show gets uploaded and posted on a whenever it's done basis. So some weeks there might be two episodes, some weeks there might be three, some weeks there might be one, some weeks there might be none. It's really just going, it's my solo project here is just going to have that freedom to it. There's no kind of time limit. We don't even fuck with an intro. We literally just hit record and go. So
that's it.
I mean, well, it's got an intro that plays at the beginning of it, but I mean, it's really interesting. At the time of this recording, the last episode was Mandy Hornsby. Actually, there's been two episodes since the time of this recording. Mandy Hornsby, who is a genealogist and a historian, and she's got her experiences living in Vietnam, Scotland, and southern Mississippi. And that was a really great conversation. We talked for about 2 hours, and mostly we talked about what life is like in the South. So that's a lot of things we could relate to one another on there. We had a good old time. And then the most recent recording is episode 4, where I talked to Adam and Jeff, and they're from the podcast You Hate. And they basically talk about most of that interview. We're going to talk about their experiences working in sports. Adam was a hockey player. Jeff was a football player. They're both having issues at this time with CTE.
Oh, shit.
So we talk about how CTE is affecting their day-to-day lives as regular people who are former athletes. And Adam and they've both got Adam works currently as a forensic. He can read body language and stuff like that. Like,
wow,
working in law enforcement. And Jeff works in the movie industry. So he helps. His most recent project was Batman or The Batman. And he was an assistant on set for that movie. And so, like I said, man, these guys, I talked to these guys for about an hour and a half, about 2 hours almost, about an hour 45, I think it was. And, you know, like I said, the show, I don't plan these interviews. These aren't really interviews. They're just conversations. So. Mm-hmm. Here's the gist of the show. You know how when you're in school and you're in college and you go down to the student union to have lunch and you sit down at a table with somebody you don't know and you guys just start having a conversation?
It's pretty much like
That's the show. Yeah. Dustin sits down with some people he don't know who have interesting jobs, lives, stories to tell, whatever.
Yeah,
and we chit chat and I've enjoyed doing it. I've learned a lot from these guys, and I hope you guys enjoy listening to it also. Is that music video ready to go yet, or?
Oh, I was just waiting for you to finish up there.
I've been waiting on it to upload. I'm stalling, man. I've been stalling this whole time waiting on it to pop up. Oh there we go.
There we go. Hang on. Let's get rid of this fucking lower third for 2 seconds here. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to
look it up. Oh, yeah. Okay.
All right. Let's do it.
Here we go. We all know that one guy in the group that wears his pants too tight. Oh, hello.
Yeah, I guess this chick comes out of the sewer.
Oh man, I recognize her.
She did the walk of shame but underground.
Yeah, hang on. That's when when your mom's like really scary. What is she? Pause, goddammit. I wanted to see her face because she reminds me of somebody and I just can't place it. Damn.
Shakira.
Man, maybe if you bought Shakira off Wish.
Yeah.
Well, at least
I don't see a bra there, so there you go. It's free to
know. Oh, yeah, I just noticed that. Yeah. Good eye, Caputo. Good eye. Don't wanna wait till you know me better. Is this a Village People music video?
Yeah. Or are they walking through a Jefferson City flood?
Yeah, that's what it was like today. Oh, hey.
Leather.
I love how there's like human skulls on the ground. We're not gonna talk about the fucking skulls on the ground.
All I see is the boots, and I'm like, Jesus Christ, 1984 called.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you, bro, if there's human skulls floating on the ground, this damn flood's worse than anyone we've seen in Jeff City. That's the remains of the people that had to sit through this music video.
That was a director, please.
Not everybody makes it, folks. Not everybody makes it.
Unfortunately.
This would be a good tang.
Yeah. Was she like, was that like an actual fluid? Or was that like fucking like gasoline? Like they pour like flaming tables and shit.
It's tang.
It's tang? Sweet Kirsch Pertanger.
Do you know what tang is?
What the? I do not know. I'm too chill for this shit.
Okay. Back in the 70s, there was a drink called Tang. Have you ever heard of Ovaltine?
No.
Okay, it's like old people drink. So, like, Tang is this powder that comes in like a kind of like a jar, kind of like a coffee, how coffee comes, not really in a jar, but a can or whatever, with that pop off lid. And you get you a glass of water. You get you a scoop of Tang, you put it in the water, you mix it up, and it makes like an orange drink.
Oh, okay. That's like, was it like a vitamin C thing? Or
no, it's just a gross-ass drink from the
70s. Oh, it's like fucking Crystal Light, kind of.
It's like when you go to your grandma's house and she makes Ovaltine or fucking Tang or something for you when you're a kid, because that's what they drink.
It's kind of some, what was like those like fucking things you'd freeze and you put it in like a thing of water and makes
juice. That's
frozen. I don't know. Okay, this is different.
That's juice.
I'm thinking like Tang, 20 different things.
Tang is just a fucking orange flavored powder.
Okay, so the powder is flavored.
Yeah. So that was my joke. Is she's drinking Tang while somebody out there is old enough to get that fucking joke.
Yeah, it's weird how they're trying to like present this like friggin' like or like jungle here. Or it's like. Like a fucking dystopian jungle, but it looks like the fucking back parking lot of like a resident, like a industrial area. It's like, we get it. This is the fucking Universal MGM back lot. You guys shot this on. Like, shut up.
They were literally in the street just a minute ago, walking with skulls floating and shit.
Yeah, is this where they shot Dancing in the Street?
It's that same street. This is a follow-up music video to Dancing in the Street. This is 100 years later in the dystopian future.
Yeah, into the multiverse.
Yeah. Oh, Lord. Here we go. Let's get a good look at these boys.
Gene Simmons looks like a grandmother, honestly. It was so weird, like, the unmasked, like, Paul Stanley looks like Paul Stanley, whatever. But then, like, Gene Simmons is, like, I don't know. He's, like, freakishly tall. And he has, like, this like, weird, like, fucking fro of a hair. It looks like an 80s grandmother, basically.
Okay, turn your rock and roll. Oh, they lost 6 inches when they took off the platform shoes.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, I was going to say.
Who's this ugly chick on the end in the Japanese flag shirt?
Oh, fuck. I got to see who's in the lineup at this time. Hang on.
Actually, I think he's dead. I don't want to piss nobody off because I do like Kiss.
We do, yeah. But let me see. Look it up. Who's in the band at this time?
Who's the guy pretending to be Ace Frehley?
Yeah, look it up. Let's see here. So Gene Simmons, Eric Carr was on drums, R.I.P. Or that could be Vinnie Vincent, actually. This is when Vinnie Vincent was there.
Yeah, I think that's Vinnie I'm looking at. I think Eric's, I could have.
Eric's on the far left, I think. I think you're right. Vinnie Vincent is on the right there. Like
Vinnie Vincent's look like that chick you hooked up with in college. that you regret.
Then they like changed the then they changed the face paint. He had like some other weird one. Where it's like friggin' like religious iconography, whatever.
Yeah, it was like a Catholic cross or something. Then there was a guy, and he was the fox instead of the cat, because they changed it up when Ace and Peter left originally, and then when they put it back on, they just started pretending to be Ace and Peter. Well, they came back with Ace and Peter when they put the makeup back on.
Yeah.
And then when they did that farewell tour, which is basically them kicking Ace and Peter back out of the band and bringing in the guys that are in it today, they just put Ace and Peter's makeup on, and nobody knew the fucking difference, and still don't to this day, unless you're a diehard Kiss fan.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to hit play. Gene looks like he's mad at you for fucking...
Yeah.
This is like the face your grandma makes when you break her favorite vase.
Yeah, it's like when you take the...
Like right there. There it is. When grandma's coming at you because you broke your favorite vase. That's Gene Simmons. You
fucking took the plastic off my couch. I'm going to fucking wind spin your ass. Boom. Like that.
Oh, man. I'm in pain. Oh, man. That made my ribs hurt. Fuck me. Oh, that was funny.
They're like snapping his fingers. What are these guys, like the fucking outsiders?
Oh, he's got the Gene's kind of got that Razor Ramon thing like going on.
Yeah, and like, Paul Stanley's leaning more into it. He's actually fucking my vibe. Gene's like doing like the big tall bad boy watch. Like he's Kevin Nash or something.
I'm so sorry, Gene. You can't be the demon out of the makeup. It don't work.
Yeah, it just looks weird.
Oh man, look at this. They're eating whipped cream.
It's a nighttime party? What the fuck?
They're drinking heavy whipping cream.
Is that mixed with
custard? No, just custard.
It's fucking.
That's a birthday cake they're passing around.
And this fucking
and gasoline.
World of a back lot.
Yeah. They're drinking custard and gasoline. That's.
Yeah, this is the best way they could hide the drugs in this music video.
Probably wouldn't even let them show booze on TV back then. I know what it is. You know those juices that your mom would buy you when you was a kid that would have that peel, that tin foil lid that would peel off?
Yeah. It's those fucking like disposable like grab and goes.
Yeah, that's what they're drinking. Oh, they've got cake on their face.
Yeah. Oh, they finally found instruments.
Paul Stanley is less pretty without makeup on.
Yeah, Gene Simmons has a weird tan boy. It's like, oh, I just tanned my face and my chest, and then that's it. Like, you'll see when it goes back to him.
Yeah.
Like, oh, my God.
Got that far.
I was gonna say, there's some pro wrestlers who have shitty tan lines and have better ones than Gene Simmons does.
Yeah. We get that a lot in the indies because these are like working class fellas. They get their shirt off in the ring and they got kind of like how I got that line that starts.
At yeah. You. They just do like the shitty spray on thing. They don't even go to like a tanning bed. It's like, like blasting it like it's fucking Axe body spray.
I don't know, man. That shit turns you orange like Donald Trump.
Oh, yeah. It's not spray on. It's just, it's like, it's there for like 5 minutes. You sweat and it just, it's awful.
Why he's not wearing a white shirt. Oh man, this is pretty bad.
Yeah, this is just he's like trying to maintain eye contact. Oh no, bro, look at this face.
I love that Gene's trying to be Gene, but Gene is just not Gene without the makeup, man. This is not Kiss to me. I think this is the worst Kiss song. So are these the Chicks again, or is this Kiss again?
No, it's Kiss. But more Vinnie Vincent, please.
I'm having a hard time keeping up. Where'd the girls go? They've been gone for a hot minute.
Yeah. They're like, oh, shit, sorry, guys. We have to play a show in, like, fuck Iowa or something.
they got the girls there. They started a music video with girls in it, and then it just switches to this shit for the rest of the time. There's no storyline whatsoever. Oh, wait, there's a hot girl.
Kiss finds out a city exists. We have to play a show there.
So these girls came in to be the music in the music video. They were in, like, I would say...
the first, like, minute?
10% of the fucking video.
Less than a quarter, I'd say.
Were they charging by the fucking second?
Maybe. Those would be some expensive fucking, you know, call women or whatever, you know, ladies of the night.
Ladies of the night.
I was going to say, shit, rappers probably find ladies for cheaper than that, if that's the case.
Well, ladies want to be in a rap video. Who wants to be in fucking Lick It Up?
Well, I mean, it's Kiss. You could be like, oh my God, Kiss without the makeup. Oh my God. Oh my God, Paul Stanley. Oh.
Dude, to me, Kiss, you take the makeup. This era of Kiss, I refuse to acknowledge.
I mean, some of the music was like okay, but like, eh. Just the look and the image is like, ooh. Took a while for it to actually like, look decent.
I think Lick It Up is probably the most famous song of that era.
Yeah, because even like looking when I just looked up like who was like on the track over, it says like Lick Up's been played like over 1,300 times as of August 2015, and probably even more.
Yeah, they played it. They played it when I went and saw them. They played Lick It Up. Like you wouldn't gonna get. I think out of No Makeup era Kiss, my pick for the best song that they had during that period is God Gave Rock and Roll to You.
Yeah, that fuck, what was that album called?
I don't know.
Oh fuck, I don't remember. But that was a really good album. They had like that. Every time I look, was Every Time I Look You on that album? Hang on. If I look at the albums, I will find this. Revenge. That was the album. Yeah, Revenge. That was that album with God Gave Rock and Roll to You and all those songs. Oh yeah, Unholy, Domino. Oh, yeah, Every Time I Look You was on that album. Then fucking I Just Wanna, whatever. Which they still bring back here and there, I think.
Kiss in the 90s was pretty good, like Psycho Circus. I enjoyed that shit.
Yeah, the reunion album, which they didn't even play on. They had fucking like Tommy. Oh my God.
They didn't play. Eric
playing. The rumor was they didn't play shit on that album.
Peter and Ace?
Yeah, like not. None of them. Hang on. I gotta like confirm this because it's weird. It's like. Wow. Okay, well, Toto's band effort, Pure Chris is only allowed to play tracks on one track, and Ace Frehley only played on two tracks.
Huh.
What the fuck?
Well, what do you know? Oops. I did not know that.
That's interesting. Which is weird. Yeah.
I mean, I think they're better off. The guys they got going now are solid. Like,
yeah, Tommy and
the guy that plays Ace Frehley and the guy that plays
Eric Singer, yeah. Tommy Thayer.
Oh man, let's play this song and we'll call it a night.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a short show.
Yeah, sure. Double review last time. Let me look up the lyrics while we're at it.
Here you go, bud.
Two tickets and a room. I love how I put two tickets, and the first thing I said was two tickets to Paradise. I was like, I'd rather listen to that song.
They're in the chat.
Oh, I've already found them. I just looked them up here.
Oh. What?
There we go.
It didn't want to paste in the chat? No way.
Yeah, I was like, oh, I forgot we had a chat in here.
Yeah. There.
God damn it, pal. This is bullshit. before we do though, hang on.
Let's talk about some music.
James Brown, baby.
Well, hang on just one second, guys, because you know if you're gonna talk about my music, then you should at least give me a chance to defend myself.
Oh, okay, Paul Stanley. Well, I'll give the floor to you. Defend Unmasked Kiss and defend Lick It Up and that cringy music video.
Well, you see, first off, that music video was an artistic statement. okay?
Okay.
What we were saying was everybody gets the lyrics and lick it up to be wrong. And really, the song is about all the water on the floor when there's a flood going on. And we're like, what are we going to do with all this water? I guess we better lick it up. And, you know, that's where the lyrics come from. And that's why there's skulls on the floor, because some people don't survive licking up the dirty water off the floor, like the off the streets, like the rest of us do. Because see, me and Gene, we got stomachs of steel from some of the shit we used to drink in the 80s and the 70s. So, you know, it doesn't bother us so much. But those other two guys, they got dysentery and died on the spot. And that's why there's skulls and shit and stuff on the streets there. And as far as the girls go, I mean, I like girls. Everybody knows I like girls. Okay,
we know.
Not
guys. But why are you encouraging your fans to lick dirty water off the floor? You should be encouraging them to lick some other shit. Like, you know, you like girls. Tell them to fucking lick whatever there. You know, you get the
okay. Okay, you see what you're saying. See, Chris, yeah. What you're saying doesn't make any sense. What are you going to lick off? What are you going to lick on a woman, son? That doesn't even make sense. Okay.
There's an entire fucking body you can do that to, you know.
Okay, I don't know how you go around just licking people, okay, but girls don't like that. Okay?
Yeah, consensually, damn it, Paul, it's 2022.
I've been with a lot of girls. I've been with hundreds of girls because I like girls, and girls don't like being licked on. So that's not what that's about. I don't even know what you would do with your tongue in a woman. So I don't even know where that comes from.
Okay.
The thing about Lick It Up is it's a classic anthem. And the reason that we stopped doing the makeup in the 80s was I was getting a skin condition that, you know, I don't really want to disclose my medical information, but it was making me look a whole lot older than I was. Okay. I was only 40 at the time. It was making me look like I was 41 or something. And, you know, I had to let it go for a little while. And the girls did. They didn't seem to mind when, you know, all the girls was around, because there were girls around. Okay. There were a lot of girls around. I always have a lot of girls around when I do my kids music. Always. Those aren't guys. Those are girls. Okay. I don't care what the tabloids say.
No, okay. Listen, I'll take your word for it, but I don't know. Maybe Lick It Up, you should tell your fans to fucking hydrate or something. I don't know.
Well, that's what we said. You got to drink the dirty. See, you're not listening.
Yeah, but not dirty water, Paul Stanley.
Okay.
What are you trying to give your fans? Like, no.
Okay, see. All right, so see, you know what, this was a bad idea. Okay, I'm just going to leave now. Goodbye, everybody. Thank you for listening to Kiss, and thank you for being a fan of rock and roll. You know, rock and roll is an amazing thing. It brings all of us together, okay? And you know something? The people in the city on the last episode where I showed up, they said that they don't rock as hard as the people that listen to this episode, and I think we're going to show them otherwise, aren't we, everybody?
Show him. All right. Oh,
I didn't make any sense there, Paul, but okay.
Yeah, I don't know. This guy's telling his fans to, like, fucking get diarrhea from drinking sewer water. tell him Lick It Up. It should have been like you should have thrown Gatorade at him instead of Tang or whatever. Here's some electrolytes, you fucking idiot.
Oh, man. Don't go bringing science into this.
Gatorade. Do Gatorade. Oh.
H2O.
Could name like any drink. Fucking Gatorade. Surge Cola. Surge H2O. Cola.
Gatorade. H2O.
Hey, Bobby, water sucks. Gatorade's better.
Gatorade, Powerade. It's all the same shit at the end of the day.
My mama said that. This rock and roll music is the devil. Let's see how much devil we're going to
have. Oh.
Now you're all messing with.
It's definitely different. Like heavy distorted guitars. You hear the bass too there. It's like chunky.
Oh yeah, I don't hate this.
Already had a few. into a room. They had a couple more. And they made love above the blankets against the wall and on the floor.
Hang on a second. You know what this is reminding me of?
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear that news story this week? I shouldn't be telling this, making jokes of it because somebody died, but I don't care. I'm going to do it anyway. Did you hear that news story about this crazy bitch from Alabama that broke this dude out of prison?
Oh, the one you're talking about last week. Dude, because I literally saw that a couple days ago that, like, was the guy that she ran away with, like, died or something?
No, she died.
Oh, fuck.
The cops came along and ran him off in a ditch, and he got hurt, and she shot herself.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's how that ended. But, yeah, this first line really made me think about this story, as fucked up as that is.
Hey, it makes it more relatable now to 2022, so bonus points.
Tickets and a room, two tickets.
So what, they got drunk, flew somewhere, and got a hotel?
Why wouldn't you just... They just last minute at an Airbnb, or was there like a Motel 6 with like bed bugs in it?
I was about to say, where do you live that there's not a fucking hotel around? What kind of boondock sticks do you got to live in that you got to take a plane to get to a hotel?
Yeah, that's, I don't know. Like, just fuck anywhere. Yeah, be rabid about it. Who cares?
Do it on the plane.
Be your freak on. We're going to Mile High Club.
She showed him her teeth. The scenario was classic.
Like she pulled her dentures out and showed them to him.
Directly into oncoming traffic. She could hardly speak. She had no idea where she was going. She tore her dress, peeing in the bushes.
What?
Sounds like a very,
well, that's
like
a weird fucking
thing. Sounds like a sloppy drunken night or something. She's fucking throwing off the shoes. She's fucking squatting in bushes.
Why don't you read us that second verse so we can really dissect these lyrics here and get this good, beautiful story told. Classy.
You want me to start second verse, or I could start from the top?
Start with the second. We done talked about the first one, I think.
Okay. They laid by the pool to take in the sun. She flagged down a waitress and said, "I'd like to have another one." She turned into someone else, someone he hadn't known before. She left her purse by the register at the liquor store, which is why.
Stupid. Sure. Yeah, man.
Very stupid. She showed him her teeth. The scenario was classic. She broke a heel and walked barefoot directly into oncoming traffic. Something. She had no idea where she was going. She tore her dress, peeing in the bushes. Now half her ass was showing. Two tickets and a room.
This is like the worst Tinder date ever, man.
This just sounds like the one time a married couple like gets away from their kids for a day, and they just do like dumb shit they did when they like were engaged, like not married. It's like, yeah, let's be like 25 again. Nope, that ain't working, son.
Man, I'm going to tell you, if your woman can't hold their liquor better than this, you need another one, man.
Yeah, this sounds like The Hangover, but if it wasn't just, if it was just, you know, a dude and a chick and not just a bunch of dudes. And then, like, they're like, it's not just like someone's going missing, their fucking mind has gone missing, unfortunately.
They just can't hold their liquor, man. Some people don't know how to act when they own the booze.
One drink and you're leaving your purse at the liquor store? That's not the place you leave for your tab, bro. No, I use there, man.
Taking her dentures out, pissing in the bushes.
With half her ass showing.
Oh, man.
Paul Stanley probably would like that because he likes girls, apparently. So.
Yeah, yeah. And he will tell you how much he likes girls. He's very adamant about that.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, let's hit play and hear how this fucked up story ends.
Tickets and a room. Two tickets.
Oh.
little all solo.
Right. Got a little guitar action going on. Wait, why he going to jail?
What the fuck?
Ain't that always the fucking way?
Yeah, believe the woman first.
Let's see. She told him it was over and went off in all directions. He saved her life more than once, several intersections. Then when the police arrived, they had no interest in what he had to say. He found himself in handcuffs watching her walk away. Yeah, that's about so, right.
Was this like a foretelling of the future of like Johnny Depp and Amber Heard? I mean, come on, it just writes itself at this point.
Who's this guy?
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh yeah.
That's all I can think of right now.
Oh damn, son, you killed
me. This is like a light version. They haven't told you all the other shit that went down.
Oh man.
So that's what she was doing in the bushes. She was actually, you know, shitting. Like she probably she probably thought it was the bushes. It was actually the bed. So, hashtag me poo.
Oh, my God. That's so funny. I've been watching that case unfold. They got that hot doctor in, yeah, like, last week.
Bro, then they're trying to, like, allege, like, that she's, like, doing, like, cocaine on the witness stand or something.
She was, man. Have you not seen that video?
It looks very, like, fishy because, like, she doesn't grab, like, a tissue or anything. Or unless she, like, had a tissue somewhere and was probably just doing it for, like, press photos. Oh, my God, I'm in, like, that much trauma.
She's sucking in.
Like, you're probably a bitch. So,
okay,
she's like, sucking something in.
If you're watching on Spotify and you're seeing my gross ass constantly blowing my nose and stuff, I'm blowing out. She was sucking in.
Yeah. Oh. Got me there.
That's the difference.
Yeah.
Oh, well. There's still 2 minutes left of this song. So I'm like,
two tickets and a room. Two tickets. Two tickets and a room.
Just goes all punk rock, like the tempo, like fucking jumps 20-fold. Oh, maybe. Okay, it picks up a bit. Okay, it picks off. That's pretty cool. Now it kind of sounds like Rage Against the Machine a little bit, but just less effects. Yeah, like Renegades of Funk. Well, the night that happens, Vegas is like shut down. It was like $2 billion.
Now, shouldn't let that crazy bitch get away.
Yeah, save the Hoover Dam, kids. Yeah, it's the only thing powering Vegas right now. They're fucked if that goes out.
Oh, man. I do love me some Vegas, though. I'll give you that. Yep, the lights went out. And then
the song went out.
You Bud Light Seltzer Hard Soda.
Classic cola.
And the wind blew that away. Okay.
Bud Light Seltzer. It's not bad, actually. There's my review of that.
Yeah. All right. Will you do me the honor of going first this time so I can get off camera for 5 minutes for a few minutes and
I'll let you do your thing. This actually isn't like a terrible song. Like the intro is pretty cool. Like you hear the like the chunkiness, like that distorted guitar mixed with that bass line. The bass line sounds really cool mixed with that guitar. Like, I really like that. It was pretty cool. I mean, it kind of tells a story lyrically with this song. It's interesting. It could be applied to a lot of different things, like we've already mentioned, like reviewing the song as well. Is it something that I would listen to again? Not likely. I mean, it's good, but I don't know if it's something that I would want to, like, you know, listen to over and over. Here and there, maybe. But it, like, Walking Papers is still pretty good stuff. Like, I can't complain. It's tough to review this one because, like, it's to me, it's like, I don't know if it's like, you know, like we, like, you know, like Dustin and I always say, is it playlist worthy or not to make it to like a playlist on like your Spotify or whatever your streaming thing is. It's tough to review. I'm just gonna go out and I can't give it anything less than a 3, so I'm gonna go 3 out of 5. It's a good song. We enjoyed it. Like, the solo's pretty good too. 3 out of 5, I'd say. You know, I'd give it a 3. I think it's fair to give it a 3. I want it to go a little bit less, but I think 3 is pretty good because actually we did kind of enjoy the song. So, what say you, Dustin Bones, if you get your mic off mute?
Sorry about that. I've been talking for a hot minute and it sounded like you were responding to what I was saying. So, anyway, I don't disagree. My turn.
Yes, sir.
All right. Don't hate it, don't love it. 2 stars.
Fair enough. Quick and easy, straight to the point, baby.
Yeah, I'm sick, y'all. Yeah. I'll never listen to this again. So let's spin the wheel so I can go to hell to bed.
Yeah.
I'm so, like I said earlier this week, folks, just give us a break this one time. We'll make it up to you.
We still gave you almost an hour and we're both fucking sick. You probably worse than I am right now, but still.
Yeah. We'll make it up to you. We got 2 episodes coming, what, next week or something? So
yeah, in the near future.
Yeah. 160 is now in the rear view. Let's spin the wheel and see what we're going to do next week.
The one you loved is gone by slash.
Okay.
Ah, all right. The one you loved. I think it's from, is that from Living the Dream?
I think it is. I got it in front of me, but I won't dig.
Actually,
it out.
Yeah, I have our fucking ratings database in here. Hang on.
The one you loved is gone.
Yeah, that is from Living the Dream. There we go.
Sweet.
Okay. We haven't really touched that album at all. I think we only touched like one song on that album so far.
No, well, be nice to knock another one off. I'm kind of looking forward to this one. So, guys, be sure to come back next week. We're going to be listening to The One You Loved Is Gone. Come back on Saturday for an all-new edition of, I almost said Shotcast Saturday, but no, it's getting dizzy with it now.
No, 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 no.
Yeah. And the Dustin Bertram Show drops periodically, as I've already mentioned, and Music Video Friday is on Friday. We're building us a network here, and stay tuned because they're probably going to be the Chris Caputo Show pretty soon. We'll see how
More into my musical psyche and my idea of stuff, because, you know, this is the rock and roll show. I'm probably going to do something else with the various amounts of other genres and other shit that I like.
That's why my show is what it is. It's a sanity keeping thing, man. Like, I wanted to do something else, and I love this show. I love what we're doing. I love the audience that's listening. But sometimes, man, you just need a break from the same formula that you've been doing for 3 years. So,
yeah.
And that's what we're doing. We're getting it out of our system, and you're going to be able to hear it all on our stream, on our feed. Oh, and a new episode of Band. We were supposed to tape yesterday, but I got sick. So we've postponed till, I guess, next week. So maybe this week sometime. When you're listening to this, Band will be out, and be looking for a new episode of Band, The Real Life Misadventures of Rick Dunsford and Friends, and all kinds of good shit. Stay tuned to this feed, man. Just, you're already subscribed. Just check it periodically. If it looks like something you're interested in listen to it. Hook a brother up.
Yeah. Also, shout out to everyone who's given us 5 stars on our Spotify. I think we got like over just a little over 10 5-star ratings. So shout out to you guys. Oh, wow. Our average is 5 stars. I just checked like 10, that is like 10 or something over like around there. So shout out to you guys giving us 5 stars over on Spotify.
Well, thank you guys. We really appreciate that you guys are enjoying us, and that really does mean the world to us, because we sure ain't making no money here. So the fact that you guys are listening and you're enjoying being with us is all the payment we need. Spotify, that don't include you. Don't get any bright ideas about not paying us.
Yeah.
Anyway, folks, I'm gonna go to bed. Thanks for listening. Thank you for bearing with me. I know I ruined this episode, and I'm sorry, but we'll be back next week, and I'll be better. We'll be good. It'll be fun. Be great. You'll see. Be fine.
You shall.
Anyway, until then, I'm Dustin Bones.
And I'm Chris Caputo. Join us next Monday, another edition of Guns and Radio. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, keep on rocking in the free world, not on Spotify, and peace out.